Hello, welcome back to the channel, and today is a new series. I am doing a new hiking series, and we're going to start somewhere which was my lockdown hiking spot, which is the Taff Trail. I am doing Caerphilly to Castell Coch, so let's get our let's head up to the Taff Trail and we'll start from there. We are. I'm just about walking down to the Taff Trail. Gotta be careful because this part of the Taff Trail has got a lot of horses going down there. So just don't get run down by horses, I've got to say. But when we get on the Taff Trail, there's something I want to show you which is kind of cool that it's still there. And it's quite hidden. It's like a hidden gem, I would say. A very, very small hidden gem, but it is. I don't know if you can see where I'm zooming into, but that is an old support for a viaduct. So we're going to walk a bit further down now and have a look of it. Actually, if I go by here, where I'll turn my camera slowly, pan it, you can see there is two. There's one by there and one by there. So let's go and have a look at them. Also, straight ahead is another one. This is where you're greeted with going down the Taff Trail, this old viaduct, because this used to be the Penrhos Cutting. There is actually an image now you can see in the corner of your screen. But here we go, this is another part of the viaduct by here. It used to go that way over. If you can see where my hand is pointing, it's that way over. But all this by here, what I'm walking on, used to be railway line. So this is the most clear of day one, I would say. As you can see now, I'm in amongst two of them, so I'm going to just walk you around to here. You can see this is the other one. So you can see it did go over diagonally, you can see by that. And if I walk down here, which is not a dodgy little path on the offbeat trail, you can see a little bit in the trees the other one. If you can see that little grey, I'll zoom in behind the trees, that is the other one. So this was the Penrhos Cutting Viaduct. Yeah, they are one of many things you can see while going down the Taff Trail, because I say this is probably the biggest hidden gem of the Taff Trail. We'll find out there is more. One of them, I actually did an exploring video there, so if you want to check that out, I'll link that in the video at some point. So yeah, these are the Penrhos Viaducts. And now, I'm going to turn the camera, we're going to go straight down there towards Castell Coch. And it's a very, very long, long walk. It's about half hour walk down to the turn off up to Taswell Mountain. So join me on this one. Right, I've always wondered what that is. Is it like part of the old railway line? I honestly do not know. By here, if you can hear the water, if I'm correct, from what I've heard, that little waterfall thing by there is the offshoot of the River Taff, or just drainage. So let's find out. Let's carry on walking straight ahead. I can feel rain actually spitting on me now, so this is going to be a fun one. Right, I'm not going to lie, I got a feeling that it's going to rain. Pretty, and I'm an idiot and just wore a denim jacket, so fingers crossed I can make it home before it rains. This walk does normally take 4 hours, so for 4 hours I'm gonna try and do it fast as I can, even with the stops. But it's not looking promising.
should have done an exploring video somewhere with a roof. That's all I say.
Now, I've got a few options. I can go back the way I came, to go back into Caerphilly, or go to Newport. Or I could go straight ahead this way, which I was planning to. I can get to Tongwellis, Castell Coch, Llandaff and Cardiff. Or I can go up this way and go Ponty, Merthyr, Brecon or Aberonthu. So, what way should I go? Because the Taff Trail is 40 miles. Or 50 miles. So I'm going to go straight ahead under this tunnel or bridge. It's 50 miles starting from the Mermaid Quay in Cardiff Bay all the way up to Penavan. So, if you are cycling, it is a good space to cycle. Got a little sewage waterfall over there to look forward at. I don't know why I said it that way for, but it is a 40-mile route. So this is only like 2.5 miles of it, 5 miles all round I'm walking. So let's carry on. So I'm almost like in another crossroads now. Just as I know, this way, if I go dead straight, will take me to Taffswell Football Club. It's a nice walk on that way as well. But if I go straight, they'll take me to Taffswell Football Club. But I am going this way, up there, towards Castell Coch. But when I do get up to the top of this little roadway, because this part is an actual road, I got something to show you. It is kind of cool.
Out of breath walking up that hill, but I am on the side of Taffswell Mountain. So this is where I am by here. It's the halfway mark between Penrhos Cutting and Castell Coch, but it has got some more of an amazing view. So let's flip the camera and have a look.
So have a look, you can see the mountain. This mountain by here is rumoured to house a body of a giant in Welsh folklore, but you can see a farm over there. But if we come round by here where I'm zooming, that's Nangaru. You can see the college, the estate, and if you go a bit further forward, if I zoom in a little bit more, that white building over there that looks like a nuclear power station is the university, and those houses over there is Pont y Prydd. So you've got an amazing view of the Rhondda coming on tap here. So let's just have a 5 minute pit stop and just carry on with this walk, I think.
Right, just had the pit stop now, so I'm walking straight ahead on this narrow trail. I think this part is not the railway trail, so it's like a beaten road, beaten track, however that analogy goes. But I'm going straight ahead, then it'll be a steep uphill climb to go on to the Tongwellis cliffs, and then it'll be down to Castell Coch. So it's about an hour maybe, or less than that, depends how fast I walk. But there might be a couple of stoppages here and there in between. Right. Let me take this out before I carry on. Right. I'm thinking, because obviously I said Taff Trail was about 50 miles. Obviously I'm not going to walk the full 50 miles, but I can do these vlogs split. So basically now I'm doing Caerphilly to Castell Coch, why don't the next one be Castell Coch to the Millennium Stadium? So I'll go through Llandaff Cathedral, the Rada Weir, Butte Park. I could always buy a ticket and pop into Cardiff Castle and make it like a big thing, because there's a lot on the second route. So let me know down below if you want to see Castell Coch to Cardiff or to the Millennium Stadium. So I could also film in Castell Coch that day and do quite a big video on that. So let me know on our hiking vlog. I've got something nice to show you by here actually.
Look down here, this is normally like a little waterfall when it rains down by here. But that's not it, this little dip. Look at all this bluebells by here. Painted the outside is banking in just bluebells. Spring's here, summer's here. This is like the best time to do like hikes and all that. I'm holding on for dear life by it. I don't want to go off into that water. You can see that's normally a little waterfall. It's been so dry today, it's not flowing. This cut down tree by here is like a little bit of an attraction now, because during the first lockdown when I started walking that view, it basically had to climb over it. Like, imagine climbing over it. Well, I think that might be a different tree now, because the other one was massive, but they have almost made it into an attraction. So we're going through here, because that way will take you into Tongwillis, and that's where we're going. So let's walk up here, because now we're going into Forest Vaud, which is part of the Taff Trail, is half of it. As you can see, this is where I am. Tongwillis is, or Tasswell still. And I will be walking around down to here, Castell Coch. That's the rest of Forest Vaud by here. The three bear caves, which I said I'd done a video there. Then you've got the main part, the car park, picnic area. Then if I go up that way to Pen y Bryn, that's got that's got the Black Cock and leads onto Cyffredin Mountain back home. But that's not where I'm going. I'm going to be coming back the way I came. If you want to see a Forest Vaud walkthrough, that could be another video. But let's go up this steep hill.
I'm only halfway up this hill. That bit don't look bad, but when you turn that corner, it'll just go like that. I'll have to show you, but it is tiring. This part of it is. At least one thing when I do part two, if that ever does come, it's all mainly downhill, thankfully. It's all mainly downhill, so I don't have to deal with that. But we are heading closer Tongwillis Cliffs now, where we are climbing up there. So it won't be long and Castell Coch will be in sight, or the roofs of it.
Here we are. This is just a killer. I don't even think that's the worst part yet. It's been so long since I like walked up here, so bear with. I know the line is straightening out now, so that's a good sign. When I walk back, at least there's only one incline I gotta do. That's it. There you go, that's Castell Coch, the roofs of it. So just a bit further down to my little left, we'll get there. But as you can see in the trees as well, you can see a bit of the Cardiff coast. So let's get there now.
So nearly at the end of the video. It is a nice little walk, this is, in fairness. That's why I probably chose it to be the first hiking video. The easiest way to get the way I came in is if you go to Beach Farm Butchers in Caerphilly and keep following the mud path, it'll take you down to the Taff Trail and you'll see the viaducts and whatever you need to see to get there. But a lot of people have carved on these trees here, which is kind of cool. Let's flip the camera. Here's a very poetic Edgar Allan Poe style poem by you. It'll always be remembered when someone says your name. And then just a bunny. We have these classic Love Hearts and Initials. Kiwis on tour, so are they New Zealanders? And this one's back in 2015. Look how well that looks for 2050. Ray Paris and Dave. But let's just turn around and just have a look at this woodland. Kind of eerie, got a bit of the Blair Witch vibes.
So I'm here, I'm outside the path that leads down to Castell Coch, so I'm here, steep path, which is, yeah, it's rough. I forgot to mention that's an old mine by here. You can see it, you just can't go to it. But that's where we're going now. That could be a future video, and I've actually done a video in there. Again, you can see the link in the corner by here. So, yeah, it tells you how easy the walks are, how hard, Castell Coch to Castell Coch. Yeah, so let's go down here.
At least now, when I first came down here, these fences were terrible. At least now they've actually fixed them, because at one point I felt like I was going to fall down the cliff while taking a picture of this Cardiff skyline. So that's what the next thing I'm going to show you, about walk down this steep path. This is probably the most moderate part of the path. I can see the old fences by here. This will be fun. So I'll see you down Castell Coch. Well, actually, I'm going to show you the Cardiff skyline as promised.
To know if that zoom's doing justice, hang on. Let's focus the camera a little bit more, straighten it up. But that's the Cardiff skyline. You can might see faintly the roofs of the Millennium, the Capitol building, the cinema, Boulder Plex, and the coast. It's not very clear because of pollution. But yeah, that's the skyline of Cardiff.
So you can see the trails behind me, and now, straight ahead, is Castell Coch. So now, I'm going to flip that camera, and we are going to have a look at this castle. The question is this the best castle in Wales? Just let me know in the comments.
So, let's have a look. And look at that, wow. Castell Coch is something to see. So let's walk over to get a bit more of a central shot of it.
So here I am, outside Castell Coch. Let's walk up the ramp quickly and just have a look in there. I'm not planning to go in it today, because that might be again for a future video. But let's have just pop our head in before we get to the main reception bit and just have a quick look. So yeah, this is it, Castell Coch. You can see the Cardiff skyline's over there. But I think that's it for today's video. If you have enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Let me know if you are willing to see part 2, which is Castell Coch to the Millennium Stadium, which I'll be going into Castell Coch and Cardiff Castle before ending down the Millennium Walk. If you see a river, that's the Taff. That video will have the Rada Weir and all sorts of stuff in it, so let me know below. Have a good day, hope you enjoyed the video, and peace out.